In this week's profile, we got the chance to sit down with Warriors legend Al Addles for a recent game at Oracle Arena.
Well, I'm sitting here with one of my favorite guys in all the NBA, and that's Mr. Warrior Al Addles. You've been with this franchise now 50 years with the Warriors franchise. Back when it was in Philadelphia, you moved out west, and I guess time flies when you're having fun.
Absolutely. The most important thing about it, and the funniest thing about it, I think, is I only expected to be there 1 week. You know, I believe, you know, just being in the right place at the right time is more important than anything in life, and I just happened to be in the right place.
So you come into the Warriors, and there's some established stars there and some young stars there. Talk a little bit about the roster when you arrived.
Well, obviously, you have to start with Wilt.
Yeah.
And, you know, Wilt and I were very, very close. And then my roommate was Guy Rogers, but a guy who I was very, very fond of was Paul Arizin. Paul was a perennial all-star. He won the top 50, obviously, just like Wilt. But Paul was a player who was older than we were. So he came to work, gave his 100% of his what he had to the effort, and then he went home every night.
Now, you were involved in one of the great games in sports history as far as records go. Wilt Chamberlain with 100 points in Hershey, Pennsylvania. Philadelphia Warriors against the New York Knicks. Other than Wilt and the dominance and then what we know about that night, is there any background story or any side story that you know?
You'd be surprised the number of people that I've talked to over the years who said, yeah, you played in the game where the guy got 100 points and you lost the game. A lot of people think we lost the game because of how they felt about Wilt. We actually won the game, and that was paramount. Number two, Wilt tried to come out of the game before he got to 100. And we all wanted to do what was necessary to win. And if he could have scored 200 points, we would have, and we won, that's all we wanted. So, and I remember we were sitting in the locker room, one of those old-time locker rooms, and I was sitting next to him. And water was coming down, he had a stat sheet. And he just kept shaking his head like this. And I'm going, big fella, what's the matter? He said, I never thought I would take 60 shots in a ball game. And I, you know, being a math major myself, I said, yeah, but you made 36 of them, which is better, 50%. But he was really, really, you know, upset that he had taken that many shots. And Wilt was our star, and nobody complained about it. We were all happy because the more he shined, the better chance we had to win, and that's all we were there for.
The team comes over, after a couple of years, Wilt Chamberlain gets traded. How hard was that for you because of how close you and Wilt were?
Well, you know, it really hurt because Wilt and I and Guy, the three of us, like, you know, the three amigos, so to speak. And the one thing that was very interesting about that trade, Wilt had this Rolls Royce, and he tells me, I'm going to let you keep this car for the year. And I'm going, no big fella, I'm not going to drive that car. And I told him, I said, here's what I'm going to do. I said, we're going to park this car somewhere. Because, and then he said, why? He said, you can use it, and you know, I said, well, think about this. Suppose I get a scratch on it. It's going to cost more than I make to get it fixed. And so we didn't do it. But, I could tell stories about him, things that he did that people would just not believe. But as we say, he's bigger than life.
Let's now go to the next step, because that trade actually opened
Nate
the
Thurman.
Door for Nate Thurman to
Absolutely,
play.
Right.
And one of the greats of all time. In fact, we were just in Cleveland. His number's retired there.
Oh, everywhere.
even though he only played a couple of years.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But what kind of a player, what kind of a guy was Nate like during his career?
Nate was an interesting guy in that Nate would cover up for everybody. I don't care what happened. And he would, you know, if he got fouls on him or whatever, but he really believed in that theory of the center being your last line of defense. And, you know, he just was a great teammate. My biggest complaint, you know, was the fact that when we did finally win a championship, Nate was not here. But I really feel badly about that.
I've known you for over 15 years, and so I'm going to ask you something you don't want to talk about. How did you get that nickname? The Destroyer.
Very simple. Back then guys used to make up stuff. And seriously, and I'll tell you how it happened. We were playing in Boston. There was a loose ball. It came off, and the loose ball was loose. And there's three of us going for the loose ball. Dolph Shaves, Tom Gola, and Al Addles. We all were trying to get the ball. And there was a pileup, bang. Then we all hit. Gola gets knocked down. And Dolph Shays gets knocked down, and his jaw gets broken. They were in the locker room afterwards, and Larry Costello says to Dolph, he said, boy, you got hit by the destroyer. Now all of a sudden, I'm the destroyer, and I'm going, where'd this come from? I know where it came from. They figured, okay, who are we going to give it to? The little guy from Newark who's not going to be in the league long, give it to that guy. So that's the way it happened.
Don't forget, Hardwood Classic Games coming up in December. Log on to Warriors.com for more information.